existing support, and neither have we ever had this branch of history to any significant degree, that is, the information about how human institutions actually behave. Institutions, in order to increase their industrial power and stop themselves being predictable, have tried to keep that branch of history obscure. When someone goes about obtaining part of it,
some classified document, for example, or a document about corporate strategy, or whole emails of Enron, or
something, and try to bring them into the light, processes start
to suppress that information and remove it from our shared knowledge of the world. So this particular branch is interesting to me, and the other two we already have. This one we do not have.
And when we look at all the political theories
about how the world should be or should not be, and what action should be taken
or should not be taken to push the world in one direction or another,
we should ask, under what information are these political theories based on?
Looking at it from perspective of an institution.
All institutions, all are engaged in unjust activities. Some obviously greatly exceed that of others. So when trying to find the information that will likely lead to a state of enhanced justice, we look for that information which the institution does not want released. Because that is a signal that the information can do something if it is released. And that's why I have always said that censorship, while it is something to be condemned, it is also an optimistic signal. It is always an opportunity, because censorship reveals the fear of reform by knowledge. That is, if knowledge can be drawn out, then some action will take place which will result in some kind of reform.